This is WMC, WMUC FM College Park. My name is DJ Ed, and welcome to the fifth episode of NightCrawlin, a show where I talk about movies, I play some music, and I go just a little bit mad. But before we start, a quick PSA.
Ever wonder why you feel like a complete zombie when your alarm goes off after 8 hours, if you're even lucky enough to get that much sleep? As college students, it feels almost impossible for us to get enough sleep. We're constantly told to get 8 hours, but is that really the magic number? Did you know that throughout the night, your body cycles through periods of light sleep and very deep sleep? Most people's sleep cycles tend to last 90 minutes, so if you aim for 8 hours, your alarm is likely to go off just as you're diving into deeper sleep. Try aiming for 7.5 hours of sleep and see how you feel in the morning. If you feel great, you probably nailed it and found your sleep cycle. If you don't feel perfect just yet, test out an 85 or 95 minute sleep cycle instead. Not only will you feel great in the mornings once you discover your magic number, you'll also add about 30 minutes of valuable time to your day.
All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that little PSA. Now, before I get started, because this is going to be a shorter show, it's only going to be about 15, 20 minutes, because I did come halfway, we're only going to talk about movies this time. We're not going to play any music. I want to save the music for when we have the full show next week, and we can get the whole experience all in one, instead of just trying to jam it in when there's really no time to do it. So with that said, I'm just going to talk about the two movies, and I'll leave it there for now. And then next week, we're going to go crazy. Also, if you're new to the show, the format is basically, for the first 15, 20 minutes, I'll talk about whatever movies I've seen recently. I'll give a short little review. And then for the rest of the time, I'm just going to kick back. And I want you guys to enjoy and listen to some EDM music. And again, because we're starting late, we're just going to do the movie music, the movie portion this time. But I hope you guys enjoy. All right, so the two movies that I'm going to be talking about today are Blade Runner and Blade Runner 2049. I feel like because we're all just getting back to school, I wanted to talk about a more futuristic movie, something that is both incredibly deep and also incredibly fun to watch at the same time, which is something that's really hard to achieve, you know? It's that delicate balance of being fun, but also at the same time, there's like moral lessons there to be learned. And since we're all getting back to school, I wanted to talk about these two movies that do that very well, that ride that balance perfectly. And so first off, we're going to be talking about Blade Runner. Blade Runner, a 1982 sci-fi action film directed by Ridley Scott and starring Harrison Ford, Sean Young, Edward James Olmos, among others, is a 1 hour and 50 minute ride from start to finish. The film manages to create an atmosphere that can best be described as dystopian cyberpunk, an atmosphere that is so immersive and so powerful that it has left an indelible mark on modern culture. You don't need to look far to see its influence. From the aptly named video game Cyberpunk 2077, to movies like The Matrix and even anime such as Akira. This incredible world building sets the stage for a gritty story of love, humanity, and much more. The main character Deckard, played by Harrison Ford, is, as you might be able to guess from the title of the movie, a Blade Runner, which is essentially a person hired to hunt down and forcibly retire rogue replicants, aka, in this world, robots. Along the way, he falls in love with a replicant named Rachel, and starts to question what really separates these replicants from humans. As the film progresses, the line between human and replicant increasingly blurs, until it's nearly impossible to tell the difference. Now, as you can probably tell from that description alone, Blade Runner is steeped in deep existential questions, such as, what does it mean to be human? Or what does it mean to be alive? These questions are as old as time, and Blade Runner is certainly not delving into anything new. But the method in which these questions are portrayed in the futuristic setting in which it is done delivers these dilemmas front and center on the big screen. As you can probably tell, I'm a huge fan of Blade Runner. If you know me, I thrive on movies that can both entertain on a surface level and aren't afraid to delve a little bit deeper. I love movies that make you sit and think about your life for 30 minutes after it ends. And Blade Runner does that nearly to perfection. Also, if you guys noticed, the soundtrack that I'm playing right now is from Blade Runner. And just listening to it, you can just sort of imagine in your head the world that Blade Runner is trying to build. You know, that super dystopian, super creepy almost, but also very futuristic world where everything is insanely high tech, but at the same time, the people are suffering and they're poor. And the soundtrack is just one reason why this film is so amazing. But of course, not all movies can be perfect. In fact, no movie can be perfect. And there's a few things I just don't really like about this film. For example, it's pretty much constantly raining throughout the movie. If you've ever seen the movie Seven, it's kind of that same vibe, where it's just excessive to the point where it almost drowns out the dialogue. And it's really hard to hear. Also, and this is more personal, but some of the replicants have really, really weird haircuts. And it makes it, they look super weird and creepy and very off-putting, which I get is sort of part of it, but it's just weird, too weird for me. But weaknesses aside, and to be fair, those are some very surface level weaknesses, I would still have to give Blade Runner 4 cyberpunks out of 5. Now, on to the next movie, which is Blade Runner 2049. I know, it's so shocking. I can't believe I chose the sequel to Blade Runner to talk about. But yeah, that's what we're going to be talking about today. So, I'm going to keep this one a little short. Blade Runner 2049 is a 2017 sci-fi thriller film directed by Denis Villeneuve and starring Ryan Gosling, Harrison Ford, Ana de Armas, among others. And is, if you couldn't tell by the name, the sequel to 1982's Blade Runner. Much like the original, Blade Runner 2049 sticks to the dystopian cyberpunk atmosphere and cranks it up to a whole nother level with massive architectural settings and extreme monochrome lighting. It gets to the point where every scene looks and feels like a painting. But not a very good painting. If you've ever seen any of Wes Anderson's works, you know how not just every scene, but every frame of the movie can be a painting. In this case, it's more about the setting and the atmosphere. And the painting is more creepy than beautiful, which is still, you know, can be a beauty in its own. The music in Cyberpunk 2049, which is exactly what you're listening to right now, is also an homage to the original, with swooping bass-boosted soundtracks that heighten the eeriness. If you guys were listening to that, you could hear the deep bass that really punctures like just how intense and just how dystopian this world is. Now, I'm not going to talk too much about the movie because it is very similar to the original. The vibe is basically the same, just to an extreme level. And the storyline is also very similar, but there is a plot twist at the end, which I don't want to reveal. Now, the reason that Blade Runner 2049 is, in my opinion, better than the original is because, well, one, it copies everything that the original did right, which is the story, the moral dilemmas, the music, and of course the atmosphere, and basically just heightens it up to another level. Everything just feels even more cyberpunk, even more Blade Runner. And honestly, I think that's what makes it good. It doesn't need to be anything different because the original was already good. So why not just, in a way, copy what the original did right and then just reuse it and make it better?